done there. I got South Park playing off to the side. Part one is uploading to YouTube as we speak. We're ready to move on to the next step. I figured it would be a good idea to show you guys how to mix some acrylic and latex paint. Now, on the cowl portion of this bust is going to be a mixture of acrylic and latex paint. On the face portion of this bust is going to be a mixture of oil-based rubber cement and naphtha. Like I said, these are going to be two completely different painting techniques, like two completely different ends of the spectrum. So it's going to be interesting to see it all come together. The last coat of paint that I laid down has dried, and as you can see, it doesn't make that much of a difference, but it's real subtle, and it does what we needed to do in terms of subtleties. So I'm going to show you how to mix some acrylic and latex paint. I'm going to take an empty container here, if I have one. Shit. Okay, here's one right here. Not empty. Huh. Well, I was going to mix some up just to show you guys how to do this. I guess this is one downside to flying off the seat of your pants. I don't know what the fuck I was using this for. I'll clean this out. Use it. Smells. It's definitely got naphtha in it. This is an oil-based mixture. Whatever I was using it for, I don't even remember. Everybody say hi to Django. That's my dog. She's asleep right now. Let me clean this out real good, and we'll mix up some paint here. Should have done this beforehand, but you know, this is as real as it gets in terms of, this is pretty much like you're hanging out here with me, whoever you are. I don't know who the fuck's watching this. Could be some pervert, like 100-year-old pervert that has a mask making fetish for 29-year-old weirdos. Anyways, for sakes of this video, for video's length sake, I'm not going to clean this out too good. It'll do its job. I keep a little 1 gallon case of latex down here underneath my desk for instances such as this. So I'm going to pour some latex in here. And if you've never dealt with latex before and you just got it, you should know that this shit stinks. It smells like ammonia. Almost like cat piss. I'm gonna pour some in here. And I don't need much because this is just, I'm probably never gonna use this tone that I'm getting ready to make ever again. That'll be fine. If you get latex on your hands, the best way to get it off is to rub your hands together real fast. It cures and it falls off. There you go. You can't fucking learn that on Stan Winston School or whatever, which I have nothing against. I actually used the videos for some time, and that's a fantastic source for learning things. I have a few different colors over here, as you can see. Like I said, I didn't know I was doing this, or I would have organized shit a little bit better. I'm going to use some white and a little bit of flesh tone. There we go. This is called fucking AC Flesh. You don't need expensive acrylic paints for this shit, guys. I've been using the Walmart paints ever since I started in this hobby, and I haven't had a complaint yet. However, oil-based paints get really expensive. a little bit of flesh tone in there, like that. Now, since the hood in the movie that Roy was wearing was really, really light colored, I'm gonna add some white to this flesh tone. That's satin. We don't want satin, you want flat white. Which I'm sure I've got some over here somewhere. There we go. I'm gonna put some white in there. Get my tongue depressor. Mix it up real good. Kind of trying to be fast with this video and informative at the same time, because I don't want it to be like fucking 3 hours long, but I'm quickly learning that there might not be a way around that. See, that's kind of that color that I've got right now. Now, acrylic paints dry a lot darker. The color I got right now is probably going to dry, if I were to use it right now, would dry really close to the base coat that I put on before this last coat. So I'm going to add some more white. There we go. You probably can't, it's probably not making much of a difference to you, whoever's watching this, but it's making a big difference if you were here and you could see it. Okay, I'm happy with that. So that's what we're gonna use. Ideally, you would just use a different sponge to do this, but since for time reasons and all that shit, and on top of that, this bust is going to be mine personally, so it's not going to a customer or anything like that, so I'm not really that concerned about doing things legitly, you know, but it's not going to look any different regardless, but I'm just going to use the same sponge that I used last time, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm hoping you guys can see. I never know where this thing is pointed. And like I said, the face portion of this, because we want it to look realistic, I'm going to be doing a lot of airbrushing on it. It's going to be completely different. It's going to be done using oil-based paints and rubber cement with a mixture of naphtha. I'm just going to dabble this all over the hood here. Getting it good and uneven and you know, natural looking. You don't want it to look like it's been done by hands. Want it to look organic. That's the word of the day, organic. Some of you guys from fucking up north, you New Yorkers and shit, probably thinking, who is this hillbilly bastard, that accent? I hate hearing myself on camera. It is what it is, I guess. I can't change the way I sound. I'm not voting for Trump, so fuck you. Anyways, as you can see, I'm just stippling this on here. This is a latex acrylic paint mixture of about 30% acrylic paint to 7% latex. Laid down another, and this is just another tone added to already two different other flesh tones. This is probably as far as I'm going to take the different variating flesh tones on the cow itself, because obviously we want it to look fake. We want it to look like a latex cow that somebody has purchased in the 80s. So we're not going for realism on the cow, we're going for realism on this face. So, I'm gonna go ahead and try to get the motherfucker to sit up straight first. We're gonna let this dry, let this cure. This is the end of part two. I'll get back to you here in a minute. When we come back, we're gonna lay down an acrylic coat over this hoe. whole thing, and then we'll wipe it off, and you'll see what that does. And then we'll get into the nitty-gritty, this portion, which is going to be the fun part. You know, this, we want this to look real.